The Little Plant Doctor, A Story About George Washington Carver, by Jean Marzullo and illustrated by Ken Wilson Max. I'm a very old tree. I live in Diamond, Missouri. Old trees like me have stories to tell. My favorite story is about a little boy named George Carver. He came to visit me long, long ago, when this place was just a farm. I was little then. George came right up to me and said, "Little tree, we're the same size." Then he smiled and said, "I have an idea." George dug holes around me. He set wildflowers into the holes and talked to the plants. If a flower drooped, George asked, "What's the matter? Too much sun? Too little sun?" He moved some plants from sun to shade and others from shade to sun. He studied how much water they needed. "Do you need more water?" he asked. "Or less water?" George studied the leaves, the stems, the roots, and the root ball of each plant. A root ball is the ball of soil that clings to a plant when it is lifted from the ground. George handled his plants carefully because he didn't want any part to break. "I wish I could go to school," he said. "What am I going to do, little tree, if I can't go to school? There's so much I want to learn." George talked with Uncle Moses. Moses Carver and his wife, Sue, owned the farm where George and his brother lived, and they took care of the boys. "Little George," he said, "you were so sick when you were a baby. You will always be too small and weak for farm life. You love plants, but you can't work in the fields with your brother and me. What will you do when you grow up?" George said, "I really want to go to school." "I know you do," said Uncle Moses, "but it's the 1870s. The only school here is for white children. You can't go to school with them." So George stayed home, helping with housework and studying plants. He learned how to help sick plants get better. He cured sick plants for people, like this neighbor whose flowering plant wouldn't bloom anymore. One day George told me, "Little tree, guess what? People have started calling me the Little Plant Doctor." George told me that Aunt Sue taught him to read and write. She had a spelling book that George read over and over. He loved to read. Years passed, and one day when George Carver was about 12, he came to tell me some good news. "I'm going to school," he told me. He said that he was going to a school 8 miles away in Neosho. George gave me a hug and said, "I will miss you, little tree." I was sad not to see George anymore. His garden died because nobody took care of it. How could they? No one knew where it was except for me. Then, one day, when George Carver was a young man, he came back for a visit. "Little tree," he said, "you're so big now. Guess what? I'm going to college. I'm going to study painting, singing, and plant science." George told me he had given himself a middle name. His name now was George Washington Carver. I always wondered why George picked that middle name. I've heard some people say that he might have called himself George Washington Carver after the first president of the United States. They think that maybe he had a hunch that someday he too would be famous. I'm just a tree, so I don't know what a president is, but I do know that George Washington Carver did become famous. How do I know that? Because so many people now come to see where he grew up. The Carver Farm is a big park now. It's called the George Washington Carver National Monument. Today, park rangers take people on tours through the park. They tell school children that George Washington Carver became one of the most famous scientists ever. He worked and taught at Tuskegee Institute in Alabama. He worked in a laboratory where he found new uses for peanuts and sweet potatoes. George Washington Carver was also kind. He gave his ideas away for free because he wanted to help people. I'm glad to see that black and white children go to school together today. The children and I listened to the park ranger say, "This tree may have been little when Dr. Carver was a boy. Maybe this tree saw his secret garden." I did, I say, but they don't hear me as they move down to the path to see the Carver house on the farm where George grew up. Maybe someday you'll come and visit me at the George Washington Carver National Monument in Diamond, Missouri. I don't know what a computer is, but the ranger says that you can use one to learn more about the park. Since George Washington Carver always loved to learn, I wonder if he would have loved computers as much as he loved books. What do you think?